18-year-old JeTannue Clayborn and 21-year-old Lala Brown were talented musical artists on the rise. In 2007, they were shot and killed at the studio near 55th in Lisbon. To this day, no one has been charged.
Thanks for being here today. I'm Xavier and I'm back with another video for you. If you like this content, make sure to hit that lovely red subscribe button. And you can also find me on Instagram at the Black Case Files, as well as on TikTok, also on the Black Case Files. Today, we're just gonna have a short little chat about Miss Lala Brown. Lala was an up-and-coming R&B star that was literally shot down in her prime. In the clip at the beginning of this video, you heard a bit of her singing on s.e.x by Life Jennings. Yolanda Rose, or Lala Brown, was a Midwest girl who was born on May 20th, 1986 in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. She was the baby of five, and her parents had stated that she had a talent for entertainment from her first steps, always singing and dancing around the house. So it was no surprise to those who knew her when she began to pursue a career in music. At the age of 11, Brown started singing professionally using the stage name Premier. She often sang at weddings and later various bars. She attended Frederick Douglass Elementary School, Jackie Robinson Middle School, and Milwaukee High School of the Arts. At the age of 16, in 2002, Brown gave birth to a daughter, Amira Ariel Brown. At the age of 19, Brown traveled to Atlanta, Georgia in hopes of furthering her career, believing there she would have a better chance to meet artists, producers, and songwriters who could help assist her in pushing her career forward. She finally got her big break that she was hoping for when R&B singer-songwriter Life Jennings asked her to be on his new track, s.e.x. She was a featured singer and she appeared in the music video. The track s.e.x was a cautionary tale warning young women about the pitfalls and dangers of unprotected sex and appeared on his second studio album, The Phoenix. She then toured with Jennings but was released following a disagreement with him. Not really sure what that was about, but it happened. So in June of 2007, Brown returned to Milwaukee, still set on becoming a solo artist, and she began working on her debut album. She recorded three songs, I'm Feeling It, Rescue Me, and Give Them What They Want. Give Them What They Want was a song that a lot of people believe was autobiographical. They were all released prior to her death. On October 19th, 2007, Brown and her record producer boyfriend, Laton Kool-Aid Clayborn, were shot and killed by an unknown gunman in the Loud Enough Productions recording studio. And this was in Milwaukee. Both had been dead for at least 3 days when their bodies were discovered. Although autopsies were performed on both Brown and Clayborn, results were never released. Brown was survived by her daughter, her mother, her father, her siblings. Lala's funeral was held on October 25th, 2007 at the Mason Temple Church of God and Christ in Milwaukee. Hundreds of people attended, including Life Jennings. As of right now, the case has been featured on America's Most Wanted. That was back in February 2010. And October 22nd of 2012, TV1 aired a Celebrity Crime Files episode about Lala Brown's life and death. However, as of last July, the case has not been solved, and police continue to search for a suspect and a motive for the killing. Like I said, this is just going to be a little short one, so I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, friends, and I'll see you next time for a little Black Case Files. I try to upload about 3 to 4 times per week. You can always follow my Instagram at the Black Case Files and also on TikTok. Again, I know this was super short. This was just a little something extra because I have her on my list and I wanted to make sure I at least said a little something about it. So, all right, till next time, guys. See ya.